everybody. My name is Melissa and welcome to my channel. This is also our family channel with my husband and I and our two little kids. So today I'm going to be doing a newborn and postpartum must-haves, things that I think are super essential when you just have a newborn baby and you're going through this postpartum journey. So if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to our channel and you like what we do here, then be sure to subscribe and turn on your bell notifications so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Okay, so if you're new here, I'm just gonna give you a little bit of background about myself and our family. So I am married to my husband, Jason, and we have two little babies. Addison is 20, she'll be 22 months old. Actually, no, she's 22 months old now, and Finn is going to be 6 months in 2 weeks. So they're 16 months apart, and it is a lot of work being a parent of two under two, but it's also a lot of fun. So I'm just happy to share my experience and my insights with you guys on what I thought would be good for newborn essentials and postpartum essentials. Alright, so let's get right into these newborn and postpartum must-haves. I'm going to start with the newborn must-haves. So my first number one essential that you guys need is a nursing pillow. So this is the nursing pillow that I used with both Addie and Finn. I got the super cute cover for it because the other one was really girly. And so I got this one for Finn. And this is super essential because whether you're nursing or you're bottle feeding, it doesn't matter. You're gonna want a nursing pillow so that you're comfortable while you're nursing your baby and so that you're not like hunched over and hurting your back. So this I found was super essential, especially in the middle of the night for those late night feeds. You can just keep it beside your bed, grab it, and just use it. And then I also had Finn propped up on it when he was really, really little and he couldn't roll. So yeah, this was super essential. I would highly recommend having a nursing pillow, whether you're breastfeeding or you're bottle feeding. So the second essential that I would recommend for newborns is vitamin D drops. So these are the vitamin D drops that we use. They were the Jamieson brand. I'll have all of these products linked down below for you guys. But it's super important to have vitamin D drops for your baby if you're breastfeeding because they're not getting vitamin D through the breast milk. So you need to make sure that you're supplementing with vitamin D drops. So the third essential for newborn is a sleep sack. So what we did for both of our kids was when they were first born, we had a swaddle blanket for them. And Addison has her swaddle blanket still. And I've kept it aside as like a keepsake, and then I'm gonna keep this one aside for Finn as well. This is the one that we used when he was first born. For the first few weeks, these swaddle blankets are lifesavers. You wrap them in really tight and it helps them to sleep really soundly. But what I find is, at least for our kids, after the first few weeks, they're strong enough to wiggle themselves out. So as tightly as we would wrap them in these swaddle blankets, they'd always manage to find their way out. So what I would recommend after your baby has grown out the swaddle blanket is to use a sleep sack with Velcro. So the ones that zip right up the middle, and then they have the two wings, and then you can fold that over and that keeps them really snug and secure. But sleep swaddle blankets are super essential for newborns. And it's nice to have something to bring them, like we used this in the hospital with him, and then we brought him home and then we had him wrapped in this as well. All right, so the next thing I highly recommend for a newborn is having a bassinet that is a co-sleeper, so you can pull it right up beside your bed. I found that this was super helpful for me because Finn woke up every like 45 minutes to an hour to feed. And so it was really helpful to have him right beside me so that I could just look over at him, pick him up, nurse him, and then put him back to sleep. So having a bassinet that is a co-sleeper is super helpful when you have a newborn. So So the next thing I highly recommend is having a swing. Now it doesn't have to be like the traditional swing. We also have like a floor seat that vibrates and can swing as well. I just find that this is super helpful when you need to get some stuff done. You can just put your baby in the swing. It helps to soothe them. Some of them come with vibrators on them, and then also with like music, so that helps soothe them and helps them to sleep. I found it super essential for when we had Finn, because he was a really tough sleeper, and so like I said, he'd wake up like every 45 minutes to an hour, and sometimes even nursing him wouldn't calm him down and get him back to sleep. So most nights I would go downstairs and I'd put him in the swing in the middle of the night and have him sleep in there, and I would sleep on the couch and just strap them in, because I found that that was like the best way to help them to get to sleep. So if you have a fussy baby and a baby that's not the best sleeper, then I'd highly recommend using a swing. The next essential that I'd recommend is having a tub for your sink. So some people just use their actual sink to bathe their baby, but I would recommend getting like a little bathtub for your baby so that you can bathe them babies in a little sink that goes, or tub that goes into your sink, than putting them into the actual bathtub because they're just too small. So the next thing that I'd highly recommend for your newborn is to have a bunch of burp cloths on hand, because you're gonna have a lot of spit up. Sometimes the babies are gonna throw up. But it's just good to always have these around so that you can always have them on you, so that if there's any mess, then they're just spitting up onto your burp cloth. I didn't use them very much with Addison because she didn't spit up that often, but I found with Finn, he would spit up, and he still actually spits up, and he's 5 months old. So having these burp cloths is really essential. The next thing is this shopping cart hammock. So this one is from the brand Banksy Baby, and I'll have it linked down below for you guys if you want to go check it out. But I found this to be super helpful, especially because I have two kids, and so going to the grocery store, it was nice to be able to have this. It just hooks onto your grocery cart. It works for any grocery cart, and you just put your baby inside, and there's obviously straps so that your baby is safe and secure. But it's just super convenient to make your shopping trips more enjoyable. So I highly recommend one of these. I think the last thing for newborn must-haves is if you notice I'm looking down, it's because I have a bunch of notes, so I'm just looking down at my notes. The last thing is a wrap carrier. Now, some people don't like to use the sling carriers or the wraps because they don't feel as secure. So if you don't like the wrap ones, then just get any type of baby carrier that you're comfortable with and that fits best with your body. But I really liked the sling wrap, and I used that for Finn, and that was really, really helpful, especially because you want to keep your baby close. You have a newborn baby, and it's nice to keep them close, and there's so many benefits for baby carrying. You can look online and see that there's so many benefits for baby carrying for both you and for your little one. And so I used the sling one, and it was also helpful like going out in public, like even going to church. Like when you bring your newborn baby, there's so many people that want to come up and see your baby. And I feel like people just think that they have the right to stick their face in your baby's face, even though your baby is a brand new newborn. So I found that if I had him in the baby carrier, then it was like people weren't able to come up and just stick their face in his face, or like put their mouth on his face, because he was really, like, really tight to me. So I found that to be super helpful. So thank you so much for watching. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope that it was super helpful for new time moms, or even moms that are gonna have another baby and these tips are something new for you. I hope that they help you. If you wanna see more videos like this, then definitely let me know in the comments down below, and I can do more videos like this for you guys. thank you guys for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet.